But before all of that, let's look back at the weekend slash the early part of this week, because we've just had the latest doubleheader of Players Championship events out in Germany, and Gary Anderson back in the winner's enclosure in the PDC, a first title for him since February 2020, which leads me to ask the question, is the Flying Scotsman back?
It's a tough question to answer. Is he where he was the last couple of years? No, he's much, much ahead of that. Is he back? I don't know, but he's definitely closer to being back than he's been in a long time. And you'll hear actually later in the show from Ian White about how the pandemic, among other things, affected him. But you have to think that he's not alone. I mean, Ian White says that he's not alone. Plenty of other players are still getting back to their best after 2-3 years of things being amok. And maybe Gary Anderson is another one of those players who just didn't take to the pandemic as well as some other people. Granted, he only went and made a world match play final in the middle of the pandemic, made another world final. So it wasn't like he was playing too poorly, but he didn't win any titles. And his game slowly was dropping off, especially on television. Well, what has he done so far this year? Well, he made a final a couple weeks or a week and a half ago now, his first final in a while in the Players' Championship. And he follows it up a week later with a title. He averaged over 90 in every single match, over 104 of them, over 95 in all but his second round tie, a rematch of the World Championship semifinals from God knows how long ago against Jelle Klaassen. And he's second in averages so far this year in the Players' Championship events, a fraction of a point behind Nathan Aspinall. He's playing really, really well. But that's not the same as him playing great. It's not the same as him playing over 100 for fun like we saw him at his best. You know, we didn't have Dart Connect 6 years ago, so we don't know what he would have been like at his best. But we know Michael Van Gerwen was more of a 102, 103 player. Gary Anderson was probably north of 100, which means he's still a point or 2 points below where he was at his best. Again, yes, that is speculation because we don't know for sure. But from the matches we do have data for going back into the past, the matches that there was data, because some of the boards we did have it, especially at the later stages and especially in the stream matches, Gary Anderson was usually averaging an average north of 100. To say that he's back would mean he's back playing at that level. And that would also mean he's doing that on television. Let's see how he does when he makes his Euro Tour return in a couple months. Let's see, assuming he gets to the World Match Play, which is now, after the start of the year, did not seem likely, or it seemed at the very least iffy. Now it seems all but assured. Let's see how he does at the World Match, but let's see how he does in the World Grand Prix and the other televised events. If he can be going deep and threatening everyone and playing at the level that he played like at Sunday, because there wasn't play on Saturday. But if he can play at that level like he played on Sunday, if he can play at that level that he's been playing at so far this year, then we can say he's back, or at the very least, as close to back as he's going to be. But there's still more questions to answer. He's obviously playing very, very well. He's looking like one of the best players in the world again. And at the start of the year, I wouldn't have thought that was going to happen. I could have seen him having a rebound of some sort, but I didn't think we'd be talking 2 months into the year of him being second in averages. Yes, Peter Wright's barely played any of these player championship events in his game. Is a bunch of question marks. Yes, Michael Van Gerwen struggled in his first few Players' Championship events, and that's why he's further down the averages, even though he's now playing a bit better, only winning a title along the way this past weekend. Even still, even if those players otherwise would have been ahead of him, he's still ahead of Johnny Clayton, who, despite not getting the results, is playing at a high standard. He's ahead of Gerwen Price, who will come on later. He's ahead of Luke Humphreys and Josh Rock, both two of the best players, two of the emerging stars last year, who've kicked on every bit as much, or almost every bit as much, as they did last year to start this year. Gary Anderson's obviously playing very, very well, but there's a difference between very, very well and great, and 2 months is not going to lift him into that great category that he occupied for some time. So is he back? There are signs pointing that way, but I'm not going to say he's back quite yet. I don't think I will say he's back at least until we see him on the Euro Tour stage in a few weeks' time.
Yeah, I think that's a fair assessment. And if you watched the final on Monday, or if you watched it back on YouTube in the last few days, you'll have heard Paul Nicholson, who was on commentary, signing off the end of that final by saying those words, Gary Anderson is back. And you look at what he's done this year without the Premier League, which that changed to the nightly tournament format last year. You look at Gary's record in the first 3 months of 2022 compared to the first 3 months of 2023. And I had a look and he's played more games this year. He's won more games. He's thrown more averages in the 95 to 99 mark. He's thrown more 110 plus averages as well. And he's got a title to his name as well. And you think he went the whole of 2021 and 2022 without a senior PDC title. And now he's back winning titles. And he's also back on the Euro Tour as well. He's qualified for the event in the Netherlands coming up, I think, next month. And then Tuesday this week, he's booked his spot in two more in Belgium and the Czech Republic. And if you'd have said at the start of 2023, you're going to see Gary Anderson playing PDC events in Belgium and the Czech Republic, my first thought would have been, did I miss the PDC announced World Series events in those two countries? Because it's been a long time since we've seen Gary play on the Euro Tour, 2016, so 7 years ago, and even skipping the Grand Slam qualifier at the back end of last year. And he spoke about his reasons for that, is that if he didn't qualify outright, then he didn't deserve to be there. So that's why he didn't go into the qualifier. But a lot of people were thinking, is that a sign of Gary Anderson starting to wind down towards the end of his career? And he's spoken on numerous occasions about how he spent the best part of 20 years living out of a suitcase, hotel rooms, but maybe not having all that travelling with the Premier League each week this year, having those extra practice sessions with Ryan Searle each week. That's got his hunger back for the game, and it's certainly paying off, isn't it? Because we've seen from the season so far, there was the early glimpse of it at the Masters with that monster average that he had, even in defeat, one of the highest averages that we've seen at the Masters. But I think at the start of the year, there were a lot of questions around Gary Anderson, like you touched on there. Were we going to see him at the World Match Play? He wasn't in a spot going into the start of this year. He's now well placed to be in that event. And of course, when we get towards the end of the year, the World Championship, there is going to be that runners-up money that he's got to defend. So it is a big year for Gary Anderson in terms of consolidating his place in that, not just the top 16, but the top 32. He is going to need to play a lot more events this year, make sure he's in those major events. And doing that, it's going to be playing well on the Pro Tour and getting results. And the title, he averaged just over 100 for the day across seven matches. And to keep that level over the course of a day, I think that's the biggest sign for me that he is on his way back. And his fans, they're going to be pleased to see him battling in these events, winning these events again. But I think they also want to see him going deep in the major events again. And we're not going to see him get the chance to do that for a few months until the World Match Play. But in the meantime, he's going to be pretty busy. He's going to be playing in Euro Tours, back on stages again, and he's going to be playing in the Players' Championships. And if he can keep producing the results like he has at the weekend and into the start of this week and making sure he's in those major events, then it certainly shows there is a lot more life in Gary Anderson's career at the top level. But we do need to see him have a say in these major events, I think, towards the second half of the year before we can really say that the Gary Anderson of old is truly back.